Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy, and today I'm talking about adding and subtracting like fractions. Like fractions just mean that they have the same denominator. So if you look at the three problems I have here, all of them have the same denominator. And when we have the same denominator, we keep the denominator the same, and we just combine the numerators. So in the first one, I'm going to have 7/17, because that's the common denominator. I just say 9 plus 2 is 11. Always I want to reduce to lowest terms if I can, but there's no common fraction there, so I don't, or common factor, so I don't need to worry about it. What about here? Well, I have the same denominator, which is 9x, so I keep that, and then I add the numerators. 2 plus 4 is 6. However, 6/9 can be reduced, so I need to reduce that to lowest terms. You could write the prime factorization and cancel. That's what we showed in another video. Or you could just see that they both have a 3 and divide both the top and the bottom by 3. But when you finish, notice that there's an x that's still in the bottom. We didn't get rid of that. We have 3x on the bottom. On the denominator, we have 2 over 3x. And the last one, 7 minus 1 is 6. The common denominator was 8. And instead of writing out the prime factor here, I'm just going to do it another way that you may recognize. Divide by what I know they have in common, and I get 3/4. So that's adding like fractions or subtracting like fractions, and then reducing, always reduce when you finish doing that. The last one I have here has a common denominator of 15, and so I'm going to write 15. And then I have 9x minus 8, and so it's a little jumping ahead, but it's good to see it. Well, when you have something like that, you can't really put those together. One of those terms has an x and one doesn't. So that's all you can do is just say, well, I can combine those. My denominator was 15, but on the top I just have a 9x and then I'm subtracting 8 and I don't know what that is. I'm just going to leave it just like that. Evaluate x plus y if x is 3/4 and y is 2/4. Well, that would be 3/4 plus 2/4. That's my x substituting in for x and my y substituting in for y. And my common denominator is 4, and I have a 2 plus 3, which is 5. And that's how I'm going to leave it. It's so tempting to make that 1.25 or 1 1/4. But you know what? Leave it as an improper fraction. That's a better way to go. When we talk about LCD in fractions, again, this is a review. So if you have not seen this before, this is not going to be enough to get you going. If you've seen it before, it's a quick reminder. The least common denominator means the smallest number that both the denominators would go into. So when I'm looking at something like number 6, 7/12, and 3/20, what's the smallest number that they will both go into? There's a lot of different ways to find this. But what I would suggest is you just count by this bigger number until you hit something that the smaller number goes into. So the bigger number here is 20. 12 does not go into 20. 12 does not go into 40. 60, 12 does go into 60. And you can be checking that on your calculator by dividing each of those by 12 to see if they both go into 60. So the least common denominator for this would be 60. That's the first number that 20 goes into and 12 also goes into. Now, if you don't like that method of counting by the larger number, you can do this other little method that I have. You take the two numbers and you put them side by side and you draw a division symbol under there. And then you ask yourself, what number goes into both 18 and 21? And in this case, 18 and 21 both can be divided by 3. 3 goes into 18 6 times, 3 goes into 21 7 times. Now, there's nothing that 6 and 7 both goes into both 6 and 7 besides 1, which doesn't help. So we're just going to multiply everything in our L for LCD. 3 times 6 times 7 is going to give us our least common denominator. It's a totally different method, but it works just as well. 42 times 3 is about 126, or 42, wait a second. I can't do that in my head this second and talk. So I'm going to do that. 18 times 7 is 126, yeah. Okay, 126 is the least common denominator. What about if you have three numbers? You can use either method you want. You can start by 48s and start counting by 48s until you find something that they all go into. Well, let's try that for a second. The first one is 48. Does 4 go into 48? Yes. Does 16 go into 48? It does. If you don't know, you just take 48, divide by 16, and go, wow, it does go in there. It goes 3 times. So actually, our least common denominator here is 48. So that was pretty easy to use that method. If I wanted to use the other method, I would say what number goes into 4 and 16 and 48, which is 4. 4 goes into 4 once, it goes into 16 4 times, it goes into 48 12 times. Then I'd say, okay, the 1 is done. What goes into 4 and 12? Well, 4. 4 goes into 4 once, 4 goes into 12 3 times. And then I would multiply 4 times 4 times 3. I could times 1 times 1, but that's not going to change anything. 4 times 4 times 3 is 48. So I could have gotten that answer the other way, too. All right. Whichever way you've learned for LCD is what you should do. Have a great day.